I came to California in 52, and I worked in two clubs in Sacramento from 59.
Jay Payton was actually a singer, you know, in the 50s. He worked for Music City Records, which was the East Bay's big R&B label. Music City had some national hits like WPLJ by the Four Deuces and Johnny's House Party by Johnny Hartsman.
And I happened to come to do a gig at a club called the It Club in El Cerrito. And that's where I first met Don Barksdale. And he was telling me about he's getting ready to open up his club and that kind of thing. And I didn't see him anymore until several years later. I'm working at a club in San Francisco called Fax 2. And Don was trying to get me to work for $35 a night. So it took us about 3 or 4 years before we ever hooked up. And I think the real reason why Don hired me was because he had a manager named Floyd Slaughter. And Floyd Slaughter talked Don into hiring me. So from that reunion, I worked for Don for, oh gosh, many, many, many years.
When I first met Jay, it was the 70s or the 60s. It was a long time. That's when he was at the Sportsman. So Jay is what you call a legend, I would say. And he's been around a long, long time. I call him Top Star.
Jay Payton was like sort of the central figure in all this scene as the MC of so many of the shows that went on at the Sportsman and the Showcase, as well as at the Paramount and the Coliseum. At almost any rhythm and blues event, Jay Payton was the MC, and he was, it still is a great comedian and an outstanding dancer, and just a real gentleman.
You can name them, man. Everybody played the Showcase because that was the spot. Count Basie, I worked the Showcase with Count Basie. OJs, Little Willie John, the Dramatics, Johnny Taylor, Jerry McCracklin, Marvin Holmes, B.B. King. They used to play there 2, 3, 4 times a year. Because like I said, if you came to this area, man, you had to play that spot. And at that time, you know, the entertainers were traveling in cars and on buses and things, you understand?
In Oakland, there were like the four main clubs that I remember. Were the one I used to go to the most was the Continental Club, 1658 12th Street. The building's still there, it's for rent for private parties, it has a balcony, it's a fabulous room. And people like the Temptations and B.B. King and Aretha Franklin and Otis Redding played there a few months before he died. That was the biggest club. And then there were then Barksdale's two clubs, the Sportsman on Grove Street, which is now Martin Luther King, and the Showcase on Telegraph. Artists would come there, like the ballads were one of the major attractions at those clubs until the Whispers came along, and then the Whispers like became the top vocal group.
That's when the Bay Area was smoking everything. I mean, East Bay or on the San Francisco side, this was in the 60s.
Well, Lou Rawls was making that circuit the same way. I worked with him there at the Showcase, 3 straight months he was there. That was before he really didn't have an act. Got a voice.
Well, at that time I didn't have a group or anything. I was just getting started, you know. Didn't know nothing about that part of it. So I started performing up there maybe 3, 4 times a year. I'd go up and stay like a week, 10 days, you know. And it was cool because when you work there, when you be there like a week or 10 days, it gave you a chance to really get into the community itself.
We used to play all, man, it was a trip playing them clubs because nothing but the roots, nothing but your chops. I mean, it was just raw. Remember D. Johnson and Jay Payton, Marvin Holmes? Man, I used to just wish I could carry his guitar in this room. I used to just slip in there. You know, I had no ID, so I just snuck in the place. But man, that was the place. The Sportsman, all that, man, you know.
One of the first things I remember happening when I first joined the band was, you know, we were back up there, and we had Eddie Bailey as our lead singer. performing at the Showcase and at the Sportsman Club in one night. And we were like being self-contained. We had our own PA system and stuff like that. And then took it down to the Showcase, though, on the same night, did the same show, killed the audience over there, and then packed it all up and went back over to the Sportsman Club and did it again. That night, like, we finished like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. Being relatively young musician, this was just like, you know, an amazing experience, you know, like where you get all your drive. I mean, because this is a real situation, you know, your audience is sitting right here watching everything that you do, having a great time. But, you know, like Michael said, no technology. It's all about whatever talent you have or that you think you have. There it is.